I have a whole bunch of stuff that I decluttered. Hey everyone, thanks for stopping by my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you everything that I decluttered from my makeup and skincare declutter videos. If you haven't watched those videos yet, I will link them in the description box down below for you to watch. I encourage you to definitely give them a watch because decluttering things really helps to clear your mind and clear your entire space of unwanted clutter, and that's definitely something that we need in our very stressful daily lives. This is going to be another casual video because I just don't feel like wearing makeup in all my videos, especially when I'm like enjoying myself. Like, today is such a gorgeous day here. After all that rain and gloominess from Hurricane Michael, anytime that there is very sunny weather, I feel so happy. And oh my god, I'm also really happy because that big unicorn horn pimple is now pretty much flat and I have to just deal with a little bit of a scab. So very, very happy about that. But okay, let's get into the video. I do have quite a few things and I'm just gonna pull them out randomly from the bag. And I really wanted to do this video because wow, like I'm actually getting rid of quite a few things. I'm really proud of myself. The first thing is the DHC little like facial brush, and I got this so long ago from a store here in Queens. I don't remember what the name is, but they have a lot of Asian beauty things, and I bought it because it's like so soft, and I bought this so long ago because I think there was a YouTuber, again, got all my stuff because of YouTubers, that was using something like this or the exact same product, some kind of cleansing brush. And I think this was after I was using the Clarisonic. So pretty much at the same time I was using the Clarisonic brush, I decided to get this. It was like such a dumb purchase. I liked it at the time. I think I only used it once or twice and I never used it again. So I'm gonna either throw this out or give it away. This is the Bare Vitamins. This is Bare Essentials Bare Minerals Prime Time Foundation Primer. This was my favorite foundation primer that I used for a really, really long time until I decided to try the Cover FX Calming Primer, which is the one that I use right now and I love it a lot. And this is definitely a very silicone-y primer. It feels so slick on the skin. I tried to use it like once or twice in the past, maybe like last year or something, and I did not like it. None of the concealers or powders stuck to my face when I used this. And that's really sad because this did work really well for me when I used it. This was my favorite primer and I had like, I think one or two bottles of it. This I mentioned in my skincare declutter video that my ex got this for me. It's just Vaseline, but it's so freaking old. This is literally like 8 years old. This is the Primal Pit Paste, and it's a natural deodorant that's baking soda free. I picked this up at my local health food store, and the reason I got it was because I tried the Schmidt's deodorant, and that has baking soda in it, and it only irritated the crap out of my underarms. I was using like Dove and Secret deodorants growing up, but I just stopped using deodorants at all. If you'd like a video on why I stopped using deodorants, then let me know. I was thinking about it already, so I think I'm just gonna do that like next week or whenever I have it like free in my schedule. But I did not like this deodorant either. It's very oily, it's so moisturizing, and I don't know, I just felt like it made me sweat even more. And I know there's like this whole period when you switch from using conventional deodorants to more natural ones that your body has to get used to it, so you'll probably go like weeks or a month or something having like more sweating and more smell and whatever. But honestly, I just don't care about deodorants anymore, so I'm gonna throw that out. I have two boxes of the Schick Quattro razors and a box of the Schick Intuition. I don't shave anymore. I epilate my leg hairs and I don't have to do too much for my underarms. I got laser on them I think like 2 or 3 years ago, and I'm so happy with that. And I'm planning on getting laser on my legs, so if I can just cut out everything that has to do with hair removal, then I will do that. So I'm going to give them away. I think I'm just going to give them to my boyfriend's mom since I know she still shaves. All these packages, That's what I'm gonna throw out. Oh my god, this is so old. Okay, so I wanted to do this decluttering video too because I have so many old school products. This is the Wet n Wild Ultimate Brow Kit. Tell me if you used to have this because this got me so excited when I found this at Rite Aid. God, I don't know, like 5 years ago, five, six, 7 years ago. And so many YouTubers were using this and I was like, why can't I find it in the store? So I picked it up in ash brown, which does not match my brow hairs anymore. But that was when I was like dyeing my hair and my hair was like a lot lighter. And I loved it. It's actually really, really good. I like the brush that it comes with and I like the tweezers that it comes with. I don't even know if I want to keep this, but I don't know how such a cheap product has really good tools in it. The tweezer works so well. So actually I think I want to take the tweezers out and keep it. The next product is the L'Oreal Wear Infinite Eyeshadow Quad in Very Violet, and this was another old school product, but I did not like this because none of the shadows were pigmented whatsoever. It was just basically like putting non-pigmented chalk on my eyes. This is the Dolly Wink eyeliner liquid pen thing. See, it still works. That's what really, really makes me mad about this, because it works, but every time I used it to line my eyes, which was like a total of 2 times, it was so liquidy, like it's so liquidy and watery that it just literally leaked into my eyes. It was disgusting. And I can't even remember if it stung, because I'm pretty sure something like this would sting. I don't like this, and it's really old. I got it at the same store that I got the DHC cleansing brush from. This is the CoverGirl Lip Perfection Jumbo Gloss Balm in the shade, I don't know what shade this is. This is actually a really nice balm. I love to use this for any time I wanted like a pop of color on my lips. I know it always smelled like crayons. This is the Wamisa Organic Flowers Eye Essence. I got this from Glow Recipe last year. I mentioned that I don't use this anymore because it just stopped working for me. It's not moisturizing at all anymore. And it's pretty much like almost all gone. I think maybe like a little bit like this is left in here, but I just don't want to hang on to it because I don't know what to do with it. I mean, it would be so messed up to give like an almost used product away, but maybe my boyfriend's mom would take it. I'm not too sure. So maybe I'll just leave this in another pile. This is the MAC Select Sheer Pressed Powder in NC30 was always my shade, and I hit pan on it a long time ago, but I stopped using it. It's just your standard powder. I did really like it. I used it to set one of the like cream foundations from MAC that I loved. That thing was full coverage. Like, my face didn't even look like my face anymore when I used it, but I loved it so much. And I love this powder, but it's just too old. I'm just going to depot it or depan it or whatever, and then back to MAC it if they still do it. This is the NYC Color Wheel Mosaic Face Powder, and I got this in 724A All Over Bronze Glow. I hardly use this product, and I'll tell you why. I bought one a long time ago, that was my first one, and it was beautiful. It was such a nice glowy bronzer. It looked very natural on the skin, and then I used it up, or it broke or something. And I went to go buy another one, but I don't think they had that shade anymore. So I was like, okay, well, this one looks kind of similar. It's not. It pulls so red on a skin. It just made my face look disgusting and weird. I'm not even going to use that for eyeshadow because it's just too old. This is the Ardell Brow Perfection Stencils. Never really helped. My eyebrows just grow whenever they want to, in whatever direction they want to, in whatever shape they want to. This is the Trader Joe's Hyaluronic Moisture Boost Serum. I know, these are like new products basically. I talked about this on my Instagram too, that every time I use it, I just so happen to break out. So this is in the pile of things to give to my boyfriend's mom. This is the Huxley Secret of Sahara Cream Glow Awakening. It's a full-size product. I only dipped into it once and I didn't like it because I don't like Huxley moisturizers. I find them to be really drying for my skin. So I'm gonna give this to my boyfriend's mom as well. Same thing with this little Huxley Secret of Sahara Cream Anti-Gravity. This is the Wet n Wild single eyeshadow in Kitten, and it's a really nice, like, I don't know, shimmery, iridescent purple shadow. It's one of the shadows in their single eyeshadows, just that just is not pigmented whatsoever. and it looks virtually undetectable on the eyes. I recommend Brulee and Nutmeg, which are the most popular shades from that line. I have the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot and the MAC Black Trek Fluid line. Oh my god, I love these so much, but I can never finish either of them. So yeah, this was my favorite cream eyeshadow base, and then this was my favorite cream eyeliner or gel eyeliner that I used to use, but I will back to MAC them. This is the Well People Bio Bronzer Powder in Natural Tan. This is 100% natural. If you never heard of Well People, I think you should give them a look if you're into like natural products. Unfortunately, this bronzer didn't work for me. It instead broke me out, and I have a feeling it's because there's cornstarch in here. So I'm gonna dump this. And it's so sad because I think that was like not the cheapest product. This is the e.l.f. Wet Gloss Lash and Brow Clear Mascara. It did nothing for my brows. And I used this on my lashes too. It was disgusting. I don't like these clear things. This is the Body Shop Born Lippy Strawberry Lip Balm. And I have the same one in Watermelon. These smell so good, but they're so disgusting and old that they kind of smell a little off. So yeah, not gonna put that on my lips. This is the Jessie's Girl cream eyeshadow, and I got this in a really nice pink shade. So if you guys know Fafinette X3 on YouTube, I don't know what happened to her video. She stopped uploading, but she was uploading like for a little bit and then kind of stopped again. But yeah, because she bought so many Jessie's Girl products, I bought basically almost everything that she had from Jessie's Girl, and this was one of them. But I'm just gonna throw it out because cream products are just gross after a long time. This is the Pixi Skin Treats Rose Flash Balm. Also mentioned this on my Instagram. I think it just breaks me out and irritates my skin, so I'm gonna give this to my boyfriend's mom. This is the Too Faced Melted Liquefied Longwear Lipstick in the shade Melted Peony. It's actually a really nice shade, and I think it sticks to your lips like for a really long time because I swatched it in my makeup declutter video. I think it was this one. I'm not completely sure, but it was like the only lip product that wasn't washing off my hand when I scrubbed the crap out of my hand. This one I didn't really like at all because it was so drying, and I literally only used it that one time to try it. This is the MAC Lip Glass in Purr. I bought this on my second MAC trip long time ago, so disgusting and old, but I really liked it. It is a really nice pink lip gloss. I will have to say that MAC lip glosses are really sticky. This is the NYX Mega Shine lip gloss in beige. This was one of the cult products on YouTube a long time ago, and I love these lip glosses because they smell like bubblegum and cotton candy mixed together. It's so delicious. And this was definitely one of my favorite lip glosses because it's very pigmented. Their lip glosses are very pigmented. This is another one of those Huxley products, Secret of Sahara Oil Essence. I mean, Glow Recipe gave this to me. I mean, it was in a beginner kit thing when Glow Recipe first popped up in New York City, and it came with the little cream here. And how are you gonna sell something like this when it wasn't even full all the way? And the dropper bottle is useless. Like, I can't get anything out. But either way, it didn't do anything for my skin. This is the Revlon Colorstay eyeliner in charcoal, and then the other one is in amethyst, and they both completely dried out, and I have no idea why. I always make sure that the lids are snapped on, but I guess the snap isn't even that snappy. The amethyst one I didn't really like that much because it wasn't that pigmented. But the gray one I really, really liked, and it stuck to my eyes like glue. This is the Tarte The Brow Architect in the shade medium to tan. It comes with a slanted tip here, and that's one of the things. And then you can also pop this one out, which is the shaping. It's like a little powder, and then the other side is a spoolie. This shade didn't match my hair color, and I don't even think I like the formula of it. This is one of the first eyeliners that I ever bought. So I got this back in high school a decade ago. More than a decade ago. And this is the Prestige eyeliner in white. And everybody was talking about like lining their inner rim with white to brighten the eyes, but that did not work. It just always made me look cross-eyed. This is the e.l.f. Luscious Liquid Lipstick in the shade, I don't know. There's no shade. Okay, yes, and baby lips. And I actually really like this. It was a really nice color. It was moisturizing and it wasn't long wearing or anything, but I just remember it being pretty nice. It smelled okay too, a little bit on a minty side. Oh, I have another one of the CoverGirl Lip Perfection Jumbo Gloss Balms, and this one is the shade... Oh wait, the shade was on the bottom. So the hot pink one is in... Oh yay, it's in 220. And then this one is in 205. So clearly this one was my pick, but this one is a nice nude. It just didn't show up on my lips at all. Here are my Burt's Bees lip balms. These are all open. I don't even know why I opened all of them. I guess it's like I lost one and then I picked up another one, lost that one, picked up another one, blah blah blah, but I don't like these lip balms. I used to use this one all the time because it gave a really nice tint to the lips, but it just nauseates me now. Yes, I showed this in my makeup declutter video. This is the Body Shop Shimmer Cubes. I mean, look, come on, look at these shades. Like, they were gorgeous when they weren't dried out. This is the Body Shop Grapeseed Glossing Serum to moisturize and smooth your hair with grapeseed oil. And I bought this because I was looking for, like, a nice leave-in treatment for my hair after my shower. And yeah, I don't like this. It actually... leaves my hair feeling so weighed down. Feels a little bit silicone-y. I don't think there are any silicones in here, but basically I don't wash my hair every day. So in between shampoos, I rinse my hair. And when you're using a leave-in product like this, it's not rinsing out of your hair. It's just making the hair product in your hair even more disgusting. So I'm just gonna give this away. I don't know who's gonna take it, but I'm just gonna give it away because I do not like that. This is the Mary Kay Cream Eye Color in Beach Blonde. And I got this from a cousin because she used to get free makeup and stuff. Yeah, this completely dried out, but it was really nice when I used it. It just added a really nice like pearl cream base over the eyes. I like to use this for like everyday looks. I have three of these Laura Geller sharpeners. This one broke and my mom wanted me to keep them because, you know, just in case, but I don't think they work as well as the sharpeners that I have. I bought the Urban Decay one and then I bought the NARS one. Both of them actually break my eyeliner, so I'm not really sure what is happening. This is the Revlon Photo Ready Concealer in Medium, and it has SPF 20 in it. This was one of my favorite concealers back then. Holly Annery used this all the time, and I bought it because of her. And these are all samples that I got from the Face Shop, from Huxley, and some from Sephora, and I know I won't use them, so I'm gonna give them away. And lastly, I wanted to show you this Sephora eyeshadow palette box thing that I got a long time ago. Oh my god, it opens up into more. Oh my god, I completely forgot about that. Well, thank you Sephora for making the most ridiculous extra eyeshadow palettes. They're all dried out and gross and really, really old. Some of the shadows, actually most of them, were really, 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 really bad. That was it for my video. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more videos. Click the notification bell so you don't miss a video. Follow me on my blog and Instagram. I'll leave everything that I talked about in the description box below. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys have a wonderful day and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Thank you.